Howdy folks, and welcome once more to Let's Stick Around and Escape from Tarkov. We are a scav, and we are in the woods. Who are we? Let's find out. We are Peter Kisley. We have an AK-74, a couple extra, fucking 10 round mags, great. We have a Slickers bar and a pop grenade. Sure. Yeah, full auto for 10 rounds, good joke. Ooh. So yeah, I have no idea where we are, as per protocol. I see a tank. We're on the south end of the map. Okay. This is probably going to be the last episode of Season 2 of Escape from Tarkov, and I'm going to be shelving this series until we get another good chunky patch out of Battlestate Games, and then we will be making a return down the line. I'm really waiting for them to release the Streets of Tarkov. That's like gonna be their big city zone. Once they release that, I'm basically going to live there. Okay, so that gunfire, I bumped AI spawn numbers up. We're no longer spawning 3 AI per spawn, it's back down to 1, but I bumped the max AI cap up to 50, so things are gonna be a little bit busy, and since we're in here as a scav, it's scav war, so, you know, everybody for themselves. I have no idea what's going on. I'm thinking for future seasons, what I'm going to do is copy my character stats over, so we'll have, like, persistent character progression, but we'll start with a fresh inventory. And I think that'll kind of make progression a little bit more straightforward. I have no idea. I have no idea. I'm sure this is just a fucking killing field in here, though. Ooh, that was aimed at me. Definitely aimed at... Where? Somebody's shooting at me, maybe. No idea. There's somebody outside, maybe. Maybe not. No idea. Oh! Oh! Saw that dude. Man. Must be nice being completely resistant to bullets. Alright, fine. You guys want to play like that, I'm going to come in with my real loadout and I'm just going to kill everybody. Same map and everything. Assuming we get a loading screen here. Yes, no, there we go. Nice 3-minute survival time there. Feels good, man. Well, I mean, if we're going in, we might as well go in heavy, right? See what kind of goodies we can bring with us. Come on, loading screen, there we go. Maybe, half, yes, no, maybe. There we go, okay. What do we got laying around in here? How many grenades do I want to bring? Yes. Bring some extra bullets. I don't think I'm gonna need that many extra bullets. Let's see. We've got medic. Vaseline. Painkillers can stay. We'll use Vaseline. Bandages. Do we have better ones? We do. Hemostat. Do we have the good splints? We do not. That's okay. We do have our grizzly kit, so we'll be okay. Bring some victuals. And do like the M4. Let's see. And ammo. All right. We are as loaded up as I think we're gonna get. So, PMC, Woods, 5 a.m., sure. And we'll be good. All right, so I will see you guys after the loading screen. All right. This early morning, 5 in the a.m., the sun will be rising. As for protocol, I don't think I have... I have no light sources because I'm a dummy. I have no idea where we are. However... Oh, maybe I do know where we are? Is this... I think we're on, like, the... Is this north? This is north. Maybe I know where we are? I think I know where we are. Okay. We'll be okay. Last episode was Into Darkness. This is Forward Unto Dawn, because Halo references. But no, we're on the north side of the map here. And we're probably gonna get ganked, because I know that scavs spawn around here. So if I had to guess, we're gonna get our butt shut off and not know from whence it came. I could just go maximum coward and hide in a building. Temptation is strong. Oh, let's see what we got. A light bulb. Good joke. Fuck you, game. Not looking like a whole hell of a lot else. Sun is rising, though. Like, it's not gonna be dark for too long here. Our goal... essentially... is just to survive until we can see. If I run up here... the other side of this house should be the river. I think this is where we got into a shootout last time. Yeah, this is where we killed those people with a shotgun. Alright, yeah, so here's the river. Okay. Alright, scav bridge is up there. What are our exits? Factory gate, outskirts, ZB014. Bridge extraction, I don't actually know. Oh, that's the car. Alright, so basically... let's see, looking at the map... let's come down here. This should be north. Like, northwest? Yeah, okay. From this bridge, there should be a road. And if we just follow the road south, that will get us out of here. However, we're gonna have to go through a shitload of scav country first. Well, it begins. Ow. That's a sniper. There's a sniper from, like, the other side of the map. What even? Are we bleeding? Nah, we're fine. Where the fuck? That was accurate sniper fire, too. Yeah, that sounded like it was coming from the other side of this, river here, and, like, we can't get over there. Which is some bullshit. Alright. Fine. Fuckers. Yeah, here's the scav bridge exit. Right here. I mean, it would be kind of cool if they had just, like scav AI parked over there. That would be pretty nifty. And I'm sure some of you might be wondering, Gene! What is going to be coming after Tarkov? Because we need something in the random bullshit Thursday upload slot. Well, worry not, dear viewer. I have plans. What will it be? You'll just have to find out. But it's a ways off. Alright, so... fucking son of a dick. Ugh. I'm just annoyed. by that death. Like, hey, sniper, LOL. Maximum rage. It's probably, if I had to guess, it's probably like not an AI sniper. It's one like on, fuck, what map is it? Reserve? Where there's like the train track and there's the signs that like if you go this way there's snipers. It's probably that, except it was nighttime and so I couldn't see anything. We just bumped into him and got our asses killed because video games. Alright, I mean, we're going back out. We've got shit, right? We're gonna use it. Ragman! Bro! Gimme, gimme, gimme. And this, and Jaeger that has the better helmet? No. Do one of you guys have a better helmet? Maybe not. Maybe I'm just going insane. Alright, backpack, armor, helmet, mag box, Stanig, we've got some bullets, we've got some grenades, we have our medic. Let's try not to just squander all of our food this time. Some we're gonna take the super Vaseline. Splint, bandage, hemostat. I think that's everything. Yeah, yeah. Can I? Where is this? This guy? Can I put? What is this? Green and an IR laser. No, I want like. I'm gonna get like. I mean, a laser sight on this thing would be great. Don't get me wrong. Oh god, and this is the one that goes like right in front of the fucking. Ugh. Let's not. But no, like a flashlight. How about a flashlight? I know there's one in here somewhere. Tactical flashlight, do you work with my... You do. Wonderful. Please don't go on top of it. That's all I ask. Son of a bitch. No, that looks like it's flat enough that it's not gonna fuck with my aim. Of course, I'm sure now that we go out, it's not going to be night anymore. 6:30 in the morning. Alright, again, after the loading screen, maybe this time I won't frickin' derp my stupid ass into a sniper field. I don't know, we're gonna die regardless. This is the last episode, we're gonna just fritter away everything. Okay, so how is- oh yeah, this isn't actually bad at all. Oh man, I'm gonna have to remember this. Like, this is actually pretty snazzy. Yeah, cool. Okay, where am I? Let's see, this is north. That tells me nothing. Alright, we'll putter about until I find a landmark and get my face shot off. Alright, that's factories. Is this fucking scab house? Yeah, this is scab house. Okay, so we're on the southwest side of the map. So I'm sure exits are gonna be like east. ZB-016, yeah, it's all the eastern side shit. Alright. Well, I need to get the fuck out of here. Let's run north. Before AIs spawn. We can hit ZB-014, poke around in there. I think that's up this way. Yeah, I'm curious to see now that we can actually maybe see some things. Landmine warning. Edge of the map, gotta be careful. Now that we can actually see things, I'm curious to see how many AI we've got, like, just kind of milling about. I think... ZB-014 should be over here... ish. It's like, there's the fence. Rocks. And it should be around here. somewhere. Ah, there it is. I'll still never forget the time there was a dude in here and I about shat myself. God, the lighting in this game, it still surprises me how good it is. Like, I don't know, Unity games, a lot of Unity games have like the default Unity look. Unreal games too, kind of. But Unreal, like, out of the box comes with better shader options, so that shit's easier to, like, tinker with. Not so much with Unity, but... Ooh, reflex sight. But if you put the effort into it, you make some nice Unity games, some nice-looking Unity games, as we see here. Just that most devs don't bother. Ooh, chocolate. Like, in a lot of ways, Unity has some things about it that are bad. Unity does have some things about it that are bad. The developers... Oh my lord. Immediately shot out my stomach. I don't know where that guy went off to. The developers are, like, notorious for half-assing features. Like, they'll start, oh, here's, like, this cool new thing, and they'll, like, release the basic version and never touch it again until they release, like, the replacement for that. It's a nightmare to develop with. But overall, I think Unity kind of gets a bit of a stigma that is not entirely deserved. It has some jank to it, but you can do good things. It's a tool like any other. It's kind of like Java in that regards. Everybody shits on, oh, Java is slow, Java is bad, etc., etc. Eh, it's not that bad. You just gotta use the right tool for the right job. And that's what people that don't know how to program don't understand. Seriously, use that to stop the bleeding. I wanted you to heal your stuff. So I stopped the bleeding, but it broke my stomach. What? Ugh. Alright, so now I know. You stop the bleeding first, then you mend your broken stomach. And then you heal. Okay. I mean, theoretically, we have water in a lunchbox, so we'd probably be able to putter along really well. The only downside is we get to eat that fucking health cap malice twice now, which chaps my ass. I don't know if we killed that dude. I don't think we did. I have no idea where he got off to. Oh, insert Kevin Sorbo screeching, disappointing. That dude is a fucking nut job. By the way. Fucking AI, man, they're everywhere. Son of a fuck. I don't even know. That was like a grenade. Like, on top of me, and I have no idea where it came from. None whatsoever. So we're just gonna go ahead and not be here anymore. I think if we go out that way, that's a minefield. Hell, if we go out that way, that might be a minefield. It's just minefields all the way down. 50 AI may have been too many, I honestly don't know. I honestly don't care. At this point, I don't care because we're just kind of here to, you know, sow chaos and destruction, but I bet it was that first dude, like, fucking about. Grenades look pretty neat. I gotta say. But yeah. Season 3 is going to be once we get another, like, substantial content drop. Because, like, this season started, they added, like, some new guns, and that was it. It wasn't anything too crazy. I'm thinking I might hold off on Season 3 until they add, like, a new map or something. Not because, like, I think that what we have isn't enough to keep me entertained, but it'll give me time to kind of, like, rekindle the desire to just sit and play a shitload of this. which has been how both of these seasons have been. Like, I'll record, you know, 10 episodes or whatever in a sitting, and then have backlog for weeks. But this is the kind of game, kind of like RuneScape, honestly, where, like, they'll release a new patch, I'll see something that's nifty, and then I'll veg away at it for 20 hours, and then be like, well, okay, I'm done. And I think I've reached that point. I'm not burnt out, but I think I am ready to call it for now. As for what follows, like I said, I have some ideas. 5.56 full metal jackets, huh? Are these good? 5.56 by 45? Not really. Okay, at least not according to my quick ammo chart. Oh, I wanted to jank my way up there. I tried. Alright, so there's a little camp over here, right? But yeah, it's... I don't know, I do like... Seriously, guy? Both legs! Both fucking legs! And my head! I don't even know. I'm just gonna, like... We're like fucking Tom Hanks in Saving Private Ryan shooting at the tank. That might have been Raiders, because that was like some scary tier AI bullshit accuracy going on there. But I don't know. Again, I wish that they would tell you who killed you. Like, purely for this reason, because like, I want to know. I must know. I mean, this was the dude that killed us, but like, that doesn't tell me anything. But yeah, he blew my fucking legs off. Like, something fierce. And that dude was Barracuda, apparently. He was a scav! He was one of our however many to 15 scavs we needed. But on this note, I am going to come in really quickly once we inevitably load in. Maybe, assuming we ever load in. There we go. I'm gonna come over into here. I'm gonna pop over into my overall character, and I'm doing this so that I know where we stand. Because this game does actually quite have a robust save editor put together by the community, purely for people that wanna like continue their saves between versions, because normally it wipes all your stats. So I'm gonna come in here, we can see we have, you know, good XP, we're level 14, and then I wanna come in and look at our skills. And these, can I do like most leveled? There we go. I basically just want to see skills that are above zero. And so when I come back, what I'm going to do is probably just set all of these to the base and we'll just lose all this extra XP that we got. So like at 17.3, it'll just be zero of 20. But yeah, so there we can see our highest leveled skill was endurance because I carry a bunch of shit and run a lot. Makes sense, I suppose. But on that note, I do think that I'm going to go ahead and call it here. So as per usual, folks, I hope you enjoyed this season of Tarkov, and I will see you guys in the next season whenever that comes around. Until then.